Good evening. It was all hands on deck for Labor on the campaign trail today, with senior team members rolled out to replace COVID-positive leader Anthony Albanese. And while the Prime Minister tried to capitalise on the situation, he was dogged by mounting questions about China's security deal with the Solomon Islands.
Labor turns to Plan B.
All right, well, the boss has got the bug, so you got me.
For the next week, the Labor campaign will continue without its leader while he isolates at home in Sydney.
You're going to see more of Albo's team right across the country talking about our positive plans for a better future for all Australians.
The risk of Anthony Albanese getting COVID was always on the cards. His team imposed strict rules on travelling media, but that all went out the window at the Byron Bay Blues Fest. With the opposition leader sidelined, the Prime Minister is sharply focused on running a national security campaign with a pledge of $428 million to upgrade four key Australian Defence Force air bases,
which plays such a critical role in our defence capability.
But he's still drawing flak for a secret deal Beijing struck with the Solomon Islands that could see Chinese troops based in the Pacific.
The worst foreign policy blunder in the Pacific since the end of World War II.
But when government ministers say this,
the Chinese government does not play by the same rules.
It's code. It means that our intelligence agencies have evidence Beijing has bribed Solomon Islands leaders and some in its bureaucracy. So with Labor arguing that the Prime Minister could have changed the decision by calling his Solomon Islands counterpart,
we know he not only doesn't hold a hose, he doesn't pick up the phone.
The government has taken aim at the Labor deputy. In his essay, The Tides That Bind, Richard Marles wrote, "The idea that Australia would win a bidding war with China is laughable. Equally, the idea that Pacific nations would adhere to a call from Australia to not engage with China is silly."
I think most Australians would be shocked by it, to be honest.
I mean, that is complete rubbish. We all get the threat that China represents to Australia. There's no disagreement about that. And for Peter to suggest that there is just an outrageous slur.
Meanwhile, in the peace of isolation,
I'm certainly not 100%, but I'm going okay.
And hoping that both he and his campaign rapidly recovers.
Political editor Chris Yeoman is in Sydney tonight. And Chris, will a week off the campaign trail hurt Anthony Albanese?
Well, Georgie, everyone will have a theory on if this helps or hurts Labor, and we may never be able to judge it. But let's just assume that it's not great to lose your leader from the trail in the second week of a campaign, and this election will be won or lost in the campaign itself. But before the leader came down with COVID, there was a growing chorus of Labor MPs and shadow ministers who were saying that the entire Labor campaign is a disaster. They're angry at a leader who seemed not to be match fit, at a dysfunctional campaign headquarters, and at the lack of a simple, coherent case for change. They fear that's put them on track, at best, to be bargaining for minority government with the crossbench when the dust settles on this election, Georgie.
OK, Chris, thank you for that. And you can see Anthony Albanese's full interview from isolation on A Current Affair.